are tomorrow's leaders, scientists, and entrepreneurs. What will you do to ensure that every University of Missouri student is prepared to take on the challenges of tomorrow?
Thank you. Well, first let me say one thing. There is no one who can guarantee or ensure that all the students will be prepared to succeed. If that was the case, I never would have had to give out a D or an F in the time that I was at the university. And I guarantee you I did it every single year. The job of the state with respect to higher education is to sort of provide the ingredients that you need to be able to succeed. We provide that level of funding, and then it's up to you to utilize those services to the best of your abilities to get what you need to get out of the higher education. But while I can't guarantee that every one of you will succeed, I can guarantee you at least three issues that I will be very supportive of. First, we absolutely need to increase funding for all of higher education in the state. For too long now, shortfalls in revenue have been made up at the expense of higher education. As I think we've alluded to earlier, the 2002 legislature, which was democratically controlled, and Governor Holden at the time, made the largest single tax, the largest single revenue reduction in the history of the university, almost $100 million. That was a tragedy at that time, and it's one that we cannot allow to happen again into the future. I will support all measures to increase funding for higher education, not only because it's, as people have said, it's good for the state, but I don't think people realize from an economic standpoint, it's the single best, highest paying rate of return investment the state can make. The other thing I think we need to do, and something that I will also support, is to make sure our universities are accountable to you. I think this is a very important thing. We need to make sure that there are simple, transparent grievance procedures in place. We need to make sure that credits from one institution easily transfer to another. And something I receive at least two or three complaints about each week is that we need to have instructors at our universities who are proficient in English. I don't care about an accent, but students have to be able to understand what the lecture is about, and I think that's an important issue. And finally, there's an issue coming up in this next session of the legislature that will be very critical, not only to the University of Missouri system, but especially to this campus. Senate Bill 389, which was passed 2 years ago, has a provision in it that says by this July 1st, we have to have a new funding mechanism in place for higher education. And we need to make sure that that new funding mechanism appropriately recognizes the role of not only the University of Missouri system, but in particular, the flagship institution of this state, the University of Missouri here at Mizzou. And it's not going to be an easy matter to get this passed. This will be a very contentious issue. Every other four-year university in this state covets the amount of money that the University of Missouri system receives. The University of Missouri system receives $1 out of every $2 that's allocated towards education, and this campus, in essence, receives $1 out of $4. That money and the representatives from around the state will be at trying to attack that. I mean, the formula that they want to put in place is obviously, if you listen to the people from either Springfield, Joplin, St. Joseph, are they going to be interested in getting a larger share of that money? And we need to make sure that we have legislators in place who have a strong background in higher education and who will be able to put forth the arguments necessary to ensure that we maintain the funding for our number one flagship institution in the state.
Thank you. Mr. Kelly, to help resolve the growing need for health care workers in our state, the University of Missouri system has led an effort to increase the number of medical, dental, nursing, optometry, and allied health program graduates across the state. Will you support this measure? How, and how can students get involved in the passage of this legislation?
Mrs. Wilson is talking about Prepare to Care. Prepare to Care is a bill, or not a bill, an appropriation that the universities pushed last year that failed. What Prepare to Care does is it provides for healthcare providers, encourages healthcare providers, and trains healthcare providers for primarily rural Missouri. It's important to this institution for several reasons. One, the University of Missouri is the fail-safe, the drop-dead healthcare provider. Drop-dead healthcare provider is probably a bad analogy. The healthcare provider of last resort for 85 counties. Almost no one realizes that. Prepare to Care would train healthcare personnel to work in many of those counties. And Prepare to Care will bring resources and good research to the University of Missouri. Will provide more opportunities for education at the university. In the last session of the legislature, the governor put Prepare to Care in his budget. The leadership of the House took Prepare to Care out of the budget. Representative Robb attempted in budget to put Prepare to Care back in. He failed, getting only one other Republican vote, Representative Hobbs's vote, in the budget committee. Again on the floor, he failed to put Prepare to Care back in the budget. He got only 50 votes. The vast majority of those were Democrats. He could convince very, very few Republicans to help him do this. As soon as he failed, a representative named Beth Lowe offered almost precisely the same legislation and to establish Prepare to Care in Missouri at the university and use in other colleges around the state. That Prepare to Care motion failed by one vote, with Representative Robb voting against it. Had he voted for it, we would have Prepare to Care at the university today. Now, the way I would involve, let me tell you something else. Prepare to Care was a slam dunk. Anyone who understood the legislative process could have passed Prepare to Care. The resources in its favor were too great. On the board of curators is the chairman of the Republican Party. Representative Robb did not have Mr. Russell, who's on the curators and is chairman of the Republican Party, come to Jefferson City to fight for Prepare to Care. The governor did not appear at the House to help with Prepare to Care. Either the governor or Russell could have forced the Republican majority to pass Prepare to Care. They did not do their work. Representative Robb was correct when he said next year we're going to need people who are able to fight for the University of Missouri. My reputation, well deserved, is that I will fight successfully for the university and I will put the parties in the barn. I would not have failed with Prepare to Care, and the evidence of that is ample throughout my career. I fought against my own party, my own governor, and my own chairman many, many times, in which I can give you specifics, and was successful for this institution. The difference between us is as stark as it can be and is articulated not by a desire to help the university, but by the ability to be successful. I would use students to help with Prepare to Care in this way. You guys are primarily from different places in Missouri. If you are from Macon County, the University of Missouri is the healthcare provider of last resort, or from Howell, or from Mercer, or from Scott, all over the place. I would have you, the ASUM folks, train the students who are from those rural counties and communicate with those rural legislators and rural county commissions, gotcha, about how important Prepare to Care is to the rural area. But Prepare to Care was essential and it failed. It will not fail on my watch.
Representative Hobbs, ASUM has worked for over 10 years to place a voting student member on the UM Board of Curators to try to make the University of Missouri system governance more transparent and open to student concerns and ideas.